This is a newly arrived Cape Dory 27. I just picked it up in Chesapeake Bay and brought it back here to Brunswick, Georgia to refit. It's got a lengthy job list that the new owner wants done, including he wants a electric propulsion outboard in a well in the lazarette back here, and to remove the inboard engine. It's basically in good shape though. It was a 1200 mile round trip to pick it up in the Chesapeake. Use this F250. It's got a V10 gas engine. Powerful, but it's a real gas hog. Got about 11 miles per gallon going up with the empty trailer, and about 9 coming back, so average 10 miles per gallon. You need a class 5 receiver here to tow with, and it's got a 2 5/16 ball. The Cape Dory 27 is the largest Cape Dory model that's easy to trailer because it's got 8'6" beam, which is the maximum allowable on the road in most states without an extra wide permit. And it's got moderate 4-foot draft. It's what I would call trailerable, but not necessarily a trailer sailer, because launching at a ramp would not be very easy. It could be done with a tongue extension and keel guideboards, but in general, you want to lift it off and on with a travel lift. This trailer is built by Sail Trailers in Columbus, Georgia. It's 5 years old now. Been across country a few times, still in great shape. The displacement of the boat is supposed to be 7,500 pounds, but the travel lift showed it was closer to 8,500, and it's lightly loaded. It has the mast and rigging and sails and one anchor on it, but not much else. And when the travel lift set onto the trailer, I needed to confirm that there was about 10% of the gross load on the tongue. So I set this scale, tongue scale, and cranked up the tongue jack to take the load off the truck as they set it down, and had them move the boat forward a few inches until we had about 1100 pounds of tongue weight. Need to have a 2x4 block, two of them under the keel in order to get the straps out, and also for painting the bottom later. The trailer is about 2,000 pounds itself, so with a boat loaded, say about 9,000 pounds, that's 11,000, so 10% would be 1,100. Need heavy-duty ratcheting straps, one in each corner to hold the boat in, and these are retractable, adjustable hull supports that have a pin that can be placed at different heights for different boats, and then it adjusts with the screw pad with this nut here. And I noticed these nuts try to work loose on the highway, so I put a little duct tape on the thread. Then I can monitor them and check them. He's going to want the prop shaft removed and that aperture filled in for better flow, less drag when sailing, since we're going to the tilt-up outboard well. I like the proportions of this boat. It's got a good-sized cockpit, and it has a straight coach roof to give you some headroom throughout the boat instead of having the forward part of the coach roof step down like on my Pearson Triton, where you lose a lot of headroom that way forward. Up on deck, it's a pretty stock Cape Dory. Got the bronze opening port lights, three of them on each side on the 27. And it's got these bronze chain plates, which are just deck pad eyes that are through bolted to backing plates down below. And it's got the teak tow rail and another teak rub rail on the outside. And it's showing some signs of leaking, so we'll have to address that. Mast has been supported in three places, the bow pulpit, in the center, and on the push pit rail. The deck core feels good in most places, except it's soft in the cockpit footwell here, which is typical on these boats because the factory didn't always seal where this rudder shaft tube is going through, and so water slowly migrates into the balsa core and it ends up getting soggy, which you can tell just by stepping on it. Inside looks like a stock Cape Dory 27. It's got this extended counter that overhangs the port settee bunk, and there used to be a non-gimbaled stove there, which is gone. I'm gonna have to replace that. And there's an ice box on this side under the steps. Is the Beta Marine diesel. That's a two-cylinder, 13.5 horse model, and that's got to go. That'll open up a lot of storage and access in there. Another full-length bunk on the starboard side, bookshelves. And there's 5'10" headroom in this part of the salon, and it goes down a couple inches less forward where the cabin sole is stepped up. This boat has a electric toilet with a waste tank, and all that's probably gonna go. Maybe a composting toilet will go in. He has a water-cooled air conditioner in where the clothes locker used to be. Not sure about that one yet. This insert and the V-berth will come out. And underneath is a water tank. And we may be replacing that. And then there's a chain locker behind the door forward. There's a lot of pros and cons to outboard motors versus inboard engines on these small boats, and I'll get into those in a future episode when we do the outboard well conversion. I'm going to start this boat refit project with the most rewarding job, to get rid of this diesel engine. So we have to start by disconnecting all the accessories, the fuel system, the water cooling system, electrical, and then we'll see if we can get this motor to fit out of this narrow space. Here's some of the equipment connected to the engine that we had to take out. Takes up quite a lot of space in a small boat. These seacocks obviously need to be replaced. They're all corroded. This one is the cockpit footwell drain, and it should be relocated out of that locker anyway to more directly below drain. And you can see that these are ball valves, not proper flange base seacocks. So as soon as that through-hole fitting corrodes like it is, it can snap off and sink the boat. These lead acid batteries are going to come out and be replaced by lithium batteries that will go under the cockpit footwell here, now that the engine is out. This cockpit locker lid doesn't seal very well because it's angled down here. And you can see that there's a spacer block here, and they made an attempt to put a gasket in, but it doesn't do any good because it doesn't come up to meet this surface here. So we'll have to build a frame around here that's the correct height, and then put a gasket underneath the lid. This old switch panel has got to go so we can make room for new wiring and better access. Pulling out all the old wires.